A 45-year-old female comes in with a white mass on her panoramic radiograph. What's the next step? Is this something we need to treat, or can we monitor it? The workup today on the open reduction. Welcome to the Open Reduction, your channel covering all topics oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten, and today we're working up a radiopaque mass in the left mandible. This patient is a 45-year-old female who recently saw her general dentist for a routine checkup. He obtained a panoramic radiograph and noticed this lesion. He subsequently referred her to my office for treatment. A bit more background information. This lesion is asymptomatic, and if it wasn't for this x-ray, this patient would have no idea the lesion is there. She had her wisdom teeth removed about 15 years ago. This one is somewhat unique in that it's a radio-opaque lesion. When we're evaluating lesions of the jaw on radiographs, they fall into three broad categories: radiolucent, radio-opaque, and mixed. Radiolucent means it's transparent on an x-ray. Radio-opaque means that it's opaque to radiation. And mixed means it's a combination of radiolucent and radio-opaque. I see a lot more radiolucent lesions in the office, which often, but not always, require a biopsy. Radio-opaque lesions, however, can be completely benign findings that don't require any treatment at all. Examples include condensing osteitis and focal idiopathic osteosclerosis. So, how do you tell what it is based on the radiographs? Let's take this lesion. It's a well-defined radio-opaque lesion in the left mandible, where there was a previous tooth, an impacted third molar. It's certainly reasonable to include condensing osteitis and focal idiopathic osteosclerosis on the differential, and it very well may be either one of those given the history of an extraction in the area. But there's certainly more things this lesion could be. Additional lesions on the differential diagnosis include an osteoblastoma, odontoma, cementoblastoma, and focal cementoosseous dysplasia. So the question is, what would I want to determine if this lesion needs any treatment? Should I get A, a blood workup including calcium levels, B, previous radiographs, C, a bone density scan, or D, a Tech 99 metabolic study? If you said B, you got it. I don't need to know yet whether or not this lesion is hypermetabolic or if there are any blood abnormalities. The first thing I want to know is, what did this lesion look like the last time a panoramic radiograph was taken? Is it the same or is it changing? Thankfully, the dentist who sent her over did obtain a panoramic radiograph 3 years ago, and the lesion looked like this. Clearly, this lesion is growing in size, albeit slowly. This basically rules out condensing osteitis and focal idiopathic osteosclerosis. I obtained a cone beam CT, and this lesion is causing bony changes within the mandible, specifically cortical expansion. This lesion requires removal and submission to pathology to determine what's going on. Once I get a definitive diagnosis from the pathologist, I'll be able to manage it accordingly. Check out part 2 of this video, where I have the complete surgical removal of this lesion, as well as the diagnosis and treatment. Please click those like and subscribe buttons and check out my channel for all kinds of interesting OMFS cases. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten. I'll catch you next time on the Open Reduction.